Rodents are remarkable creatures. They're the most numerous and diverse of all living mammal groups, with about 40% of all mammals on the planet right now being a rodent. And the evolutionary history of this group is just as extraordinary. It's estimated that there are about 5 times as many now extinct genera and species of rodents as there are living ones, which just shows you how incredibly prolific these creatures have been. And back in the depths of prehistory, some of these animals grew to absolutely enormous sizes. Meet Josepho Artigasia monesi, the largest rodent ever known to have lived. This prehistoric giant was first discovered in 1987, when an amateur paleontologist came across a huge skull that had eroded out of a cliff face along Uruguay's southern coastline. Shortly after finding the specimen, it was donated to the National Museum of Natural History and Anthropology in Montevideo, where it remained for many years unstudied. That was until researchers named and described it in 2008, realizing that this skull represented a huge rodent. The genus name Josepho Artigasia already existed in 2008, having been created the previous year for another species, and honors José Artigas, a national hero of Uruguay, while the species name Monesi is for the Uruguayan paleontologist Álvaro Mones, who has done a lot of important research on prehistoric rodents. So clearly one of the most significant things about Josepho Artigasia is the size of the beast, but exactly how big was this animal? Since only a skull is known, it's been difficult for paleontologists to get an entirely reliable size estimate, but it's likely that this mammal could probably reach lengths of over 3 meters and heights of potentially about 1.5 meters. In order to attain mass estimates, the paper describing Josepho Artigasia compared various measurements of the skull, which in total is 53 centimeters long, with the skull measurements of several related rodents, arriving at a mass range of between about 470 and 2,590 kilograms, and an average of 1,211 kilograms. This, the authors note, is clearly far above the previous record holder for the largest rodent, Phoberomys, which has a mass estimate of between 400 and 700 kilograms. However, another study published later in 2008 used an altered method to recalculate the mass of Josepho Artigasia, concluding that it averaged at about 900 kilograms instead, and had a smaller potential range. Nevertheless, it still maintains that this was the largest rodent. The incisors of Josepho Artigasia are worth noting too for their remarkable size. While only one of them is preserved in the specimen, it's incredibly broad and heavy, with a length of over 30 centimeters, and the paleontologists have drawn some interesting inferences from this in figuring out what the rodent may have been using these teeth for. Josepho Artigasia has been placed in the family Deinomyidae, a once diverse clade that today includes just one surviving member, the Pacarana. These living relatives are actually quite big for modern rodents, and are nocturnal creatures that inhabit tropical forests in the western Amazonian basin, as well as the foothills of the neighboring Andes Mountains. So, why did the prehistoric relatives of this rodent get so big, and what was it doing with those enormous incisors? Josepho Artigasia lived about 4 to 2 million years ago, and the locality that the holotype skull specimen comes from are beds that represent what was once an ancient estuary or delta with forest communities. Many other large animals are thought to have potentially coexisted with the giant rodent in these environments, including other huge rodents, pterobirds, saber-toothed cats, xenarthrons, including giant ground sloths, and various kinds of ungulates. The skull anatomy of Josepho Artigasia has been the subject of some discussion, as the original study describing the animal notes how it's strange that a creature with an overall very robust skull also has very slender zygomatic arches, the cheekbones, compared to similar rodents, and very small grinding teeth. This suggested that the rodent could not grind up its food very powerfully, and so probably did not feed on more abrasive vegetation such as grasses, instead probably eating softer vegetation such as aquatic plants and maybe fruits. The mystery, though, was what it was using those massive incisors for. A later 2015 study by the same paleontologists who initially described the animal used finite element analysis to estimate the maximum bite forces that Josepho Artigasia could produce and the stresses this would inflict on the skull. What they found was pretty incredible. At the third molar, these rodents could generate a bite force of 4,165 newtons, about 3 times as powerful as the bite force predicted for a modern tiger. The incisors, however, only produced a bite of around 1400 newtons, but were still able to withstand much greater forces. What was going on with this rodent then? The researchers suggest that Josefo Artigasia used its incisors in a similar way to an elephant's tusks, possibly digging up roots with them and maybe even using them to fight off predators or rivals of their own species. The enormous bite forces of the molars were then presumably used for processing tough vegetation, perhaps bits of wood like the paleontologists previously suggested. Josefo Artigasia was clearly an absolutely amazing animal. Not only was it the biggest rodent that ever lived, or that we know of so far at least, but it also appears to have had some fascinating adaptations and inferred behaviour. You certainly wouldn't want to have been on the wrong side of those teeth. It just proves that even a group of animals many take for granted or even outright dislike can have a remarkable evolutionary history filled with astonishing prehistoric oddities. Well, I really hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. A big thank you to our Patreon supporters, especially our dinosaur tier supporters Jan Owen, Corey Peterson, George Vojtek, Mike Pace, Persian Boy, Mayer's World, Matthias Bergshire, Jacob Stewart, Nicole Bueno, Pastor, Mark Fawn, Dominic Baffy, Harry Evert, and Alex Hawk. If you would like to find out more about our world, its history, and the wonderful life that surrounds us all, please feel free to subscribe to the channel if you think we deserve it, and if you would like to see more from us.